long time, and I'm on no time. Can't take no more. Wonder if you'll understand. It's just a touch of your hand behind the closed door. All I needed was a love again. All I needed for another day.
Good to be back on the boat, y'all. I was here 9 years ago, 2014.
Wow.
Yeah, I never played at 11. Back then, I don't remember being up this late. But it feels good. It feels good to be back on the boat. I was walking around. I saw every inch of it today. Because I forgot. You know, I haven't been on a cruise ship. That was the first time. This is now the second time. And I don't want to jinx it or anything. But this feels good. That feels sturdy. Let's see. What can I tell you? I've been nomading for a year. I decided I didn't really want to live anywhere. So I sold my house and I've just been traveling with this one guitar and a suitcase. I've got three pairs of pants. This is one of them. So I'm playing three shows on this boat. It's possible you'll see these pants again. I flew in from Costa Rica. I was there for a couple weeks. I got this shirt there. It was too hot to even wear a t-shirt. I had to buy something like silk, breathable. I gotta tell you something, I put all my stuff in storage. I gave away almost everything except family heirlooms, my record collection, my books, and my guitars and amps. Other than that, I got nothing. And this whole year, I haven't missed one thing. I was kind of nervous about it. I thought like, oh, there's this one pair of shoes I like, or this one jacket or whatever. There's not one thing I've missed, and I've learned so much by that. I need basically nothing except for y'all. I'm not from the South, but I like to say y'all when I'm on the Kayamo cruise because it's like an acoustic thing. I can wear a hat, and I can say y'all. I'm from Cleveland. You know. Something nice about that drawl, y'all. Anyway, I spent some time in Stockholm, Sweden this past year. I was making a new album, working with a few producers that I love, and I'd like to play you a song off this new album. This song's not out yet, but it's called Over the City. It's a song about, it's a double meaning. I mean, over the city meaning that I was over the city that I was living in and just had to get out, but also, when the sun was coming up, when I wrote this song in the morning in my bed, I had been out the night before, and I had a dinner party with some friends that someone had invited me to, and I sat next to this lovely woman, and we had the most amazing conversation. But of course, there was a lot of wine. So when I woke up in the morning, I didn't realize anything, actually. What I thought was, I wonder if any of that conversation was true. And I said to myself, I bet you a lot of people have been in that situation where you wake up the next day and you're like, was it alcohol infused, that beautiful conversation I had with that woman? Or was she for real? Because she was saying she really liked me. So I wrote a song about it, very hungover in my bed. Thank you.
said I'm beautiful, you said in your eyes. You said the way I'm looking at you is how you need it. You said no, I don't see it, but I'm a good man in disguise. Sun rises over the sea. Everything is different somehow. Last night you were talking. You said you're waiting for a man to be a man. If I fall, you catch me if you can. You said you're ready, it's gonna get heavy, you let me in. I said, it's how it always begins. Sun rises over the city. Everything is different somehow. Last night you were talking so pretty. How do you feel right now? I need to know what you're really about. What if I told you scam? 'Cause you could hurt me so bad. You said my name, is it gone?
Thank you so much. I'd like to invite a very dear friend of mine up on stage. Will you please welcome Brandon Walters? So I'm going to play you a song I wrote a while ago. When I, like I said, I grew up in Cleveland. So, anyone here from the Midwest? I wonder how you raise your hand instead of clap. That's how few people are here. You're like, you'll see me.
I thought that was kind of common on the Midwest.
It's also very polite in the Midwest. You're just like, we don't want to make any noise. We're nice, honest people. We're like Canadians. Right? I never met a Canadian I didn't like. I'm always telling the truth. Saying sorry, eating donuts. So, when you grow up in the Midwest and you move out to Los Angeles, it can be a bit, I don't know, squirrely. People are always like sharpening their angles, you know? Everyone's got an angle and people are sharpening them. Everyone wants something from you and, I don't know. You never know who to trust. Oh, I was having a rough go of it, and I decided I was going to hike up this mountain with a little baby guitar, a backpacker guitar, and look over the city, and try to have an epiphany. And it worked. It really did. And I thought to myself, as I was sitting up there with this little guitar, I was like, you know what I gotta do? I gotta write a song about my favorite things. And I play it in the morning when I make coffee and start my day that way. And then I'll be fine in Los Angeles. And it worked for a long time until I decided to nomad. Because I'm over it now. But I'm over that city. But I wrote this song, it's called Beautiful Day. I got I recorded a duet with the lovely Cheryl Crow, and it's just a happy song, and every time Brandon plays on it, it just makes me smile. And even when I'm making coffee in the morning in some hotel in Costa Rica or Mexico or wherever I am, or Stockholm, and if he's not there, I picture him playing this song. And it makes me smile.
I can sense that, and then I play it wherever I am.
It's good. So here you go, it's called Beautiful Day. Gonna wash the debts of my soul. Gonna listen to some. Actually, no, I'm about to play this at. It's an old song I wrote a long time ago, and I have to play it right now because I'll tell you a little story. So, I've loved three women in my life, like romantically, I mean, kind of my mom and my sister and family, you know, three romantic women. That the one that got away was years and years ago. We toured a bunch together for a couple of years, and the day we got home, the tour bus landed in LA and just, it was over, you know. And it was about 3 a.m, the pouring down rain, and I walked out of the house with just my guitar, nothing else. And eventually, I didn't even have a case for the guitar, just kind of in the heat of the moment, grabbed my guitar. And it was an old guitar, and I really love it, and I still have it, but it was getting doused by the rain, so I thought, I need some shelter. And the only thing I could find was this ATM vestibule. It was horribly lit, you know, with fluorescent lights, and I was just like crying my eyes out. I was just in a bad way. And so I sat down on the floor, on the concrete and on the tile. And when I write a song, it takes about, I don't know, it takes some time. It's the only song I wrote in 15 minutes my entire life. Just poured out like the rain. And oddly enough, I used to call it my victim of timing song because I thought, I'm a victim of timing right now. This is the right woman for me for the rest of my life. It's just the wrong time. And I don't know what to do, so I gotta go. And I don't know if I was right or wrong, but it just is what it is. And when I recorded the song, the only voice I could hear singing the harmony in my mind was someone I'd never met, but I was just a fan of. And she just played on the stage an hour ago. So I had never met Patty, and I wrote her a letter, and I said, here's a demo of this song I just wrote. I would love it if you sang a harmony. And I got an email back and said, I'm in Nashville. I'm helping induct Emmy Lou Harris into the Country Music Hall of Fame. But tomorrow I have time. I'll rent the studio, and I'll do a harmony for it and send it back to you. And I was like, and this is maybe one of the first songs I ever wrote. So I was incredibly honored. Not that I wouldn't be honored if it happened this minute either, because I'm just such a huge fan of hers. So I had to tell you that story because I just walked backstage. And so this was in 2006. And I just met Patty for the first time. Never crossed paths out, you know. I'd never seen her play, just got to watch her play. And it's cool. So you gotta love the boat. Yeah. This song called You Got Growing Up To Do.
You'll stand before me, surrounded by lights.
for flowers in the air this night. But the best thing I can give to you is for me to go, leave you alone, 'cause you got growing up to do. Looks like the rain's pouring down on me, it's drowning me now. All I want is to come back home. This old corduroy coat is not keeping me dry. But I can't think of what else to try. That's why the best thing I can give to you is for growing up to do.
Thank you so much. Like, I'm hoping to be like a calling bird. Maybe more people will come in. But I gotta imagine 90% of the boats asleep in their cabins. I would be too if I wasn't playing. I've been on this thing since I've been nomading. Like, I've been waking up at like 5 in the morning and going to bed at like 10. So if I yawn in the middle of a song, don't hold it against me. I'm turning to my father. He wakes up at 3:30 in the morning every day and goes for a hike in these mountains, and he's in bed by 6. I swear to God, he eats dinner at like 11 a.m. But he's healthy. He loves it. Last time I saw him, he said, yeah, I mean, I don't know. Nothing cool happens after 3 p.m. I think that should be my new merch shirt on the back. Nothing cool happens at the
future. You know everything by 3 p.m.
Right? Like, you know how the days are. Yeah. And he likes wine a lot, so like I'm always like, I always send him nice bottles of wine, and I know he drinks them. Like, must be at like noon. Dinner wine. Or 10 a.m. breakfast. Alright, so I got another story for you. A while back, I had my first bout with writer's block. I'd never had that before. Because I didn't grow up as a musician. I wanted to be a painter when I grew up. So I bought a guitar when I turned 30 and learned like G, C, and D, learned a few chords, and started writing songs about 6 months after that. And I've been doing it ever since, and so I kind of fell into it, luckily. And so, I don't know, I guess I was 30 and I was like a man already. And I had all these things to say for my entire 30 years I had lived. Rather than being like a kid who gets a guitar from his parents for Christmas when they're like 11 and starts learning Metallica in the garage. I never went through that. You know, I was listening to my parents' record collection. It was all Sam Cooke and the Beatles and Aretha and Joni. So, I went 15 years without ever having writer's block. I just would always sit down with the guitar and be like, I got something to say. And so finally when that happened, I was terrified and I thought, well, it's over. I had a good little run. I'll probably have to go find a real job now. parents are worried. And so, after 6 months of writer's block, I thought maybe I could change locations. So I flew to Spain, and I found this beach that no one was on. Very remote beach. And I sat down there. I sat there while the sun was setting, and I thought, this is so inspiring and beautiful. If I can't write a song here, it's over. So I started writing. Nothing came out. And then this dog, stray dog, came out in the middle of the sand. And we locked eyes. Really, we locked eyes from about, like, up that terrace, about that far away. Yeah. And we locked eyes, and I was like, you know what, this has been my problem. I had another epiphany, like on the top of that hill in LA. It was, the dog seemed so present and in the moment. And that was my problem. I realized that I had so much anxiety about what comes next, what comes next, what comes next. Why can't I sleep? What comes next? And the dog was just like looking for shelter and food, and that's it. And I was like, how do I be more like that dog? And so I was like, I'm gonna write a song about being in the moment, and then every time I play it, I'm just gonna think about being in the moment. I'm not gonna think about tomorrow, and that's what I'm gonna think about right now. So I called the song Here Right Now, and I decided, because the dog inspired it, the stray dog, I decided to donate all the money that I make off this song to this great animal shelter. It's the world's largest no-kill animal shelter. It's called North Shore Animal League of America. If you want to look them up, they save so many cats and dogs. They're amazing. I play concerts for them all the time. And, again, it's North Shore Animal League of America. Please look them up. If you've got a few dogs, send them their way. It's called Here Right Now. I've seen much more than most, much less than some. Took a while to give up the ghost, thought it would come. There were times blood on my hands, I tried to wash away. Outside the lines, I couldn't stand without a soft voice to say that I'm here right now. Not lost, but I found, and everything I've done has brought me here. Got a scar, I don't try to hide. It's real. Gone hard, so long I find it. Can't know why. You'll never know what you can be till you come to realize. In the rear view, all that has hurt you is just a passing by. Everything. thing been going on? It's like, is it over 20 years?
15.
This is 15? This is number 15? Clap if you've been here all 15. Wow. What's your name?
Barb.
Barb? And what's your name? Lois. Who else clap? Canadians? What's your name?
Bob and Patty.
Bob and Patty. Anyone else? What's your name?
Tamron.
Wow, so we got lifers. I'm honored to play for you. I mean, all y'all are cool. 15. Wow, all 15 years. That's impressive. You love music. You're the best people. I mean, everyone here loves music. You get on a ship, music's playing everywhere. You must love music, right? Because other cruises, I would imagine, stop in other places, like a lot of places, and you can get off. This is just like hanging on a boat, listening to music everywhere you go. Yeah, I'm not a boat person, per se. I'm wearing these bands for they work. But the reason I came back after 9 years of doing this 9 years ago was because I had this amazing memory of all these people who loved music so much that they would get on a boat and not be able to leave. That's incredible. Here's to all y'all, here's especially the people, like the six of you that I just counted, that have been here all 15 Cayamos. They should give you something, you should get it for free. You tell them I said so, they're gonna be like, who said that?
We're recording this, right?
Yeah, they're like, oh, so he'll pay for it, right? Record I made during the world shutdown. I made it while I was locked away in my house alone.
You tracked your vocals in your closet.
Yeah, we did. Brandon was like one of the only people I saw for a year. I mean, I love him, but
that's a long time.
Yeah. I'll play this one. It's called Hey You. You know.
Yeah. Celtics. Boats are rocking. Beds are rocking. Well, the thing is about me and water, it's not the thing. Because when I was 5, I got a hole in my eardrum, a punctured eardrum. This is getting personal, but I mean, it's only 12 of you here, so it's fine.
13.
So, the doctor told me you could never put your head in the water. It's true. That's why I live my life on the land. But here I am on a boat. And every bad is too loud. I can't listen to myself. I need somewhere I can go. Underwater is where I go. Talk to me. I can't hear what they're saying. I need somewhere I can go. Underwater is where I go. Underwater. That's where you find me. Someplace I've never been. I wrote for that girl. I'm telling you this because it's about to be Valentine's Day, and I've never been someone who cared at all about these Hallmark holidays. You know, I'm a man. But women like are always like, I don't know, in my experience, those three women I did it, they'd be like, oh, you gotta have this, you gotta do this for these holidays, and I'd be like, but I write you songs every day. That's so much more romantic than working all day, all year, and then getting the flowers one day a year. Like, but again, maybe that's why I'm still single. I've heard that women are meant to be loved, not understood. And I don't know. There's so many quotes about love. So many good. One of my favorites is Willie Nelson's. He said, I'm sure you've heard this. In case you haven't, I love this. It's like 99% of the world isn't what the person they want to be with. And that's what makes the jukebox play. But on that note, here's a hopeful love song that I tried to win her back with. It didn't. But it went number one in 10 different countries. So, I mean, whatever. It's a trade-off. I bought a house. I didn't get her back, though. It doesn't compare. One day, I feel like we'll see each other in an old folks home one day and be like, on walkers, and be like, I still love you. Maybe we'll see each other on Kaiama. Maybe she'll play Kaiama like 10 years from now, and I will. And we'll be in the artist lounge. And I'll be playing that You Got Grown Up To Do song, and she'll be like, I'm grown up.
Spring flowers, man. Spring flowers.
It's just the happily married men. I always listen to you. I should always listen to you. 10 years younger than me, and so much wiser.
Dumb luck.
That's what a really wise person always.
I could have saved so
summer's time for us had I seen a way to get to where I am today. You waited on me for so long. Listen to me say, I need to be bold, need to jump in the cold water, need to grow with a girl like you. Finally see you naturally. I'm gonna make it so easy when you show me the truth. Yeah, I'd rather be with you. Say you want the same thing. Say you
to stay up this late. For real, I'm not making a joke. Because when I saw the schedule and I was like, ooh, getting on the boat, playing 11 in this theater, I was like, I'm gonna be playing to myself. Thank you for the few of you who stayed up. I remember the sound
your November downtown. And I remember that you a warm December evening, but I have to make this mistake, and I don't have to stay this way. If only I could.
Thank you all for coming out tonight, by the way. If you see us around the boat,
we're drunk.
Feel free to say hi. This is about my favorite songwriter of all time. It's the first song I ever learned to play on the guitar. Named Robin Zimmerman. He's got a future.
last minute. Go right there.